friends, just today I am going to discuss some numeric problem. So let's see, first we need to the import some library, like from scpy import linalg.la, from scpy sciencepy import optimize, and import science simp dot init underscore printing, import numpy as np, import matplot dot pyplot as plt. So I have imported all these library and need to one more library, I think numpy. So import numpy as a np, numpy as a mp, and import panda as a pd, import panda as a pd, panda as pd, right? So these are the basic library to solve your problem. And let's try. We have already discussed these functions like linear, non-linear, and eigenvalue. So today I am going to discuss something more. So next, one of the more thing, like 1 minute, please. So just we have discussed like equation solving, and after that I try to understand like how to symbolic problem specifications, these solving like this, and then non-linear and low univariate equations. Other just I am going to try to solve like a graphical visualization of how the bisection method work. So see that in non-linear graph, so first try to understand to means why are we using bisections. So this is the approximate location of the root to an equation. So we can apply the one of the technique, like you can say also the many techniques you can also apply there, but for a numerical root finding need to the get here this technique for a numerical root finding, and which typically applies an iterative scheme where the functions is evaluated at successive points until the algorithms has narrowed in on the solutions to the desired accuracy, to standard methods that illustrate the basic idea of how many numerical root finding methods work are the bisection method and the Newton method. So the bisection method, first we try to discuss like a bisection method required to a starting interval, like if you write the square brackets and a comma b, so such that a functions a and functions b have a different sign, so this guarantee that there is at least one root within this interval. So in each iteration the functions is evaluated in the middle point like m between a and b, and sign of the functions is a different at a and m, and then the new interval a comma b will equal to m. So it's chosen for the next iterations. Otherwise, the interval a will equal to m comma b is chosen for the next iteration. So this guarantees that in each iterations the functions has a different sign at the two endpoints of the interval, and in each iterations the interval is halved and therefore converges towards the root of the equation. So the following code example, like a demonstrator simple implementations, let's say the bisections. So I am going to write here bisections. So let's see here, we are going to discuss bisections. B I S E C T I O N. So let's try this some code here. So define a functions like you can start, because your interval like a and b. So first I am write here f will equal to lambda l a m b d a x. This is the Python coding. And now the np like a numpy dot exp means exponential of this x minus 2. And tol will equal to 0.1. A comma B, right here, A comma B will equal to, we will start from minus 2 comma 2, and next variable like here x will equal to np dot linspace and will equal to, we will start from line space minus 2.1 comma 2.1, and you are taking a total number of variables like a 1000. Okay, so I hope this is like this variable we have already created. Yeah, it works. So now then let's try to the graph the functions f. So now right here f like a figure. So fig, I have already discussed what is a fig. So you need to go, and now ax will equal to plt dot subplots parenthesis 1, 1, fig size will equal to 12, 4. Okay, so it has been plotted look like this. Now let's see, just I am going to plot like x will equal to like ax, so need to here write here ax dot plot ax dot plot, because I have created a ax as a variable's name of this space. So ax dot plot parenthesis like x as a variable, I think we have created np dot line space comma functions x. So if parenthesis x, and then after that, if you want to like a LW means low, so like here I write here LW will equal to, you need to write here 1.5 and something. Okay, so this variable has been printed like, okay, just I got into some problem, matplotlib, I think if lambda, what is this, f, lambda has been created, why did I get some problem, like a 6, what is the problem, name, no, is not defined. Where you know? Okay, see here. Where you know? Oh, this is not a no. This is an empty, I think, here. How do we write the empty? Empty here. So, yeah, this is a plotted, I think, nonlinear expressions you can see here. Okay. So now it has been plotted like this. So let's see, we can add the something like AX H line. So AX dot so let's see AX dot AX H line AX H line and parenthesis and this will be like a AX H line. Now it will start from the 0 comma. Now look here, ls, here is it, and will equal to, like is, will equal to this one, and your color like a k, color will equal to like k. So I think ls will equal to, yeah, so line has been created, look like this, at this height like a 0. If you want to plot this line, a straight line like a 1, so you can also write here, you can change here like a 2. So let's see what happened. So this line has been plot look like a 2. So look here. Okay. So but need here, I am going to create this line AX height of this line. So this one has been created like this. So let's see here after this. After that, I want to set AX dot. Set underscore x ticks underscore x ticks. So x ticks and parenthesis, now the square bracket minus 2 comma minus 1 comma 0 comma 1 comma 2 x dot set the y level. If you want to the label something like here, yeah, and if I want to label something like this, ax dot set underscore y label underscore x label. First you write here the x label, not a x label, so x label, and write something like a r, this one r dollar and cross dollar dollar cross dollar and this one like again one font size 18 and you write here font size 18. Okay, so similarly we can also write here the y label. So this is a y label, x label you can see here, and I can also write here the y label like so enter, and you need to write here the same, so only change the sum value like this one. You can change here the y level, and in hands of the x you need to write here fx, so write here f and this one like this font size. Okay, like this. Okay, so I have plotted here x, another is the label has been given like a fx. After that we need to find the root using a bisection method and visualize so the like in the graph. So let's see here. So I am going to write here fa comma fb, these are the two variables like fb and will equal to, I am going to assume here like one variable like fa and another variable like fb, like fb. Okay, FA and FB. So now after that I am going to plot here like AX dot plot, AX dot plot, and write A comma FA comma, so write a string Q, something like it represent as it is, and same way I can plot one is a B, but I can write here the variable like a B in hands of FP, so you can write this something like a B. So what happened? Let's see here. So in hands of, I am going to plot, so have you see here, so one is the dotted here like A and another, so dark dotted is B is here, so FA and I have plotted, one is the A and one is B, Q notation like a dot. Now I want to write this something ax.text and a comma f a, and I am going to add here some value like a plus 0.5 comma f a and 0.5, and let's represent some specific value like a dollar a dollar. Put here dollar and need to write here a and dollar. This will equal to comma, and ha will equal to, need to write here the center, and after that need to write a font size. Font size will equal to 1.8. Okay. Let's see. So we can see your plot look like this. Similarly, I can also text like another text ax text and right here b. Conclude this. V, and can I write here the B here? So B, and need to write here B. Now it's all right. Okay, so B, so A has been plotted and B has been plotted this point. Look here, A and B has been look like this here. Now after that I am going to write here n will equal to 1, so n will equal to like a 1, and while w h I l e while b minus a will equal to b minus a is greater than like something T O L and this one, and after this m will equal to a plus bracket start b minus a divided by 2. And now fm will equal to f functions m. Okay, so let's plot here another variable like this, ax dot plot. So need to write here, because this is a while function, so I am going to write here ax dot plot. So ax dot plot start from m comma fm comma q. And after that ax dot text parenthesis m comma fm minus 0.5 here m underscore percentage d dollar I think before m need to put here the dollar comma d dollar and I don't think the dollar now we put here the percentage n and ha will equal to center. And after that I am going to write here n will equal to, here you can also write n and plus and equal 1. So let's see, is it working and not working? Okay, yeah, it's working. So let's try after that. N will equal to 1. So now I am going to write here if functions. So if np dot sine and fa will equal to np dot sine and fa. Again just a comma f a will equal to m comma f a. Now go here else else. So can apply here else functions. So else like b comma fd will equal to m comma f. And after that x dot plot, x dot plot m comma fm comma r means write a red color, and I am going to write here like a marker size, so need to put here like a marker size will equal to 10. So let's try this. Says I think is it working and not working. Have I gotten the any error? So I think else okay. Cancel it and let's try again. Marker size R M and this is look like, yeah, now you can see here your plot look like this. The markers have been given. So this is a way we can, and you can also like annotate, okay, and this is called your value. This function is called the bisection methods. You can also annotate number of these. So both the line is the intercept at this point. So this is called the root approximately at approx value, like near about something. So ax dot set of titles, I can also set here the title, and I can also annotate this value like this way. So let's see, just I am going to write here. So it is a good and better for, like, see here, I have already done this project. Yeah, so need to write here ax, and after need to write a font size. Need to write here, click here, enter, write here, font size, and then after you need to write here, it's right because data I have taken like here, and you need to write here. Now after that, if you need to, you can do this point. So where should I, next here, then after that, you need to create some symbols like this, and after that please. And how I am going to the concatenate these values. So after that here, like this. So let's try. So I hope it is being I think it is properly. So look here, so root approximations at a 0.688, and if you want to set like a bisection method, so let's write here, so you can add any value like a bisection. So click here, so your titles, now you can see your plot here, but yeah, you can see bisection methods. So this is called a bisection method. So first you try to understand that this theory, you can go to Google, and this is the non-linear, so you can easily the bisections we have already described. It just is how to get a bisection, and this is the method to the with the codings, and very helpful for anyone, I hope. Thank you very much.